So this is the sixth unit. So we have done first, second, third, and fifth unit so far. So we are going to discuss unit number 6. In this unit, you'll be having some 8 to 9 questions, and this unit weightage is 7 marks. So many questions are there of 2 marks also, but you don't have any 2 marks question from this unit. So we are doing only 7 marks questions, because 1 7-mark question they'll ask you from this exercise. We need to find the angle between the direction questions. Two lines are given to us. 3L plus M plus 5N equal to 0 is one line, and second line is 6MN minus 2NL plus 5LM equals to 0. We have to substitute this line into the second one, and we have to simplify. We have to get the values of LMN by solving the equations. How to solve this one? First, we'll write given equations. In given equation, we'll write this one as 3L plus M plus 5N equal to 0, equation 1, and here 6MN minus 2NL or LN plus 5LM equal to 0, this is second one. Now we have to substitute M equals to minus 3L minus 5N. From first equation you can equate M. Suppose sometimes we don't have any multiple for L. See, here 3 is there. You have to select any L, one letter which doesn't have any multiple. See, here 3L is there, M is there, 5N. M is free from coefficient. So we are using M, we are equating it in second. We are substituting M value here. So we can write 6N first. M value we will write this one, minus 3L minus 5N. Then minus 2LN plus 5LM value equal to 0. Now we'll simplify. Same like 10th class what you have done in simplification, the same thing you have to do. 6 3 is 18, 6 5 is 30, minus 2LN minus 15L square minus 25LN equal to 0. Now arrange in order, L squares, N squares, then LN terms in between. L square here, minus 15L square, LN terms then, 18 minus LN, this is also 20, 45 minus 45 LN, negative, add the negative terms, then write it, minus 30N square. Pattern of writing, once again check it out. LMN, we have L first, before N we have L, so square of L we have to select, then LN terms, then N square terms. In this way we have to arrange. Minus is common. Multiplied whole equation with minus sign. Then 15 common. Divide the whole equation by 15. 1 15 times, 15 3 times, 15 2 times, 0 by 15 is 0. Divide all the values by 15, divide all the values with minus sign. Now we have to split this middle value. Factorization. Those who don't know factorization, they can remember for now. 3ln can be written as 2ln plus 1ln, then 2n square as it is. L is common, L plus 2N, plus N is common, L plus 2N. Then L plus 2N common, L plus N equal to 0. Now we have L plus 2N equal to 0, or L plus N equals to 0. Now LMN, in line we have 3 variables. L is there, M is not there. You can write 0M plus 2N equal to 0. This process you have to remember. Then here L plus 0M plus N equal to 0. Next, this is 4th equation. You can take one partition, solving 1 and 3, solving 1 and 4. First one, to solve this one, second term, same you have done in straight line, same thing, second term, third term, first term, second term. Second, third, first, second. Second term is 1, third term is 5, first term is 3, second term is 1. in that way. Then from third one, second term, third term, first term, second term. Here, second term, third term, first term, second term. LM1. Here L divided by AD minus BC. M divided by AD minus BC. N divided by AD minus BC. So L by 2, M by minus 1, N by minus 1. Here we have L by AD minus BC, M by AD minus BC, N by AD minus BC. So L by 1, M by 2, N by minus 1. DRs, these are the DR, direction ratios of line 1, 2, minus 1, minus 1. Direction ratios of line 2 is 1, 2, minus 1. Check once again what we have done. Find the angle between lines they have given. Two lines are mentioned to us, two direction cosines. From that we have to find direction ratios, means element values. First equation, we have to take any one variable and we have to substitute in the second one. We'll get two factors like this. These two factors are taken as two lines by taking m value as 0. Here also m value is 0. Then we have to solve first one and third one. Solve first one and fourth one. You'll get two values, two direction ratios you'll get, line 1. Once you solve 1 and 3, you'll get some values. 1 and 4, you get some values. So these two values you have to substitute in cos theta formula. Cos theta equals to A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 by root over A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root over A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. So this is A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 by root over A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root over A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. 2 minus 2 plus 1 divided by root 6 into root 6. 2 cancelled, 1 by root 6 into root 6 is 6. This is cos theta. We need angle, so theta is equals to cos inverse 1 by 6. Once you follow 3-4 questions, you'll get that definitely. Find direction cosines of the lines which are connected. See, direction cosines they have given. We need to find that. Two lines are there again. We have to write given lines. L plus M plus N is equals to 0. First one. Then second one as it is. MN minus 2NL minus 2LM equal to 0. This is second one. first two. Then you have to write, put L is equals to M goes that side, minus M, then N goes that side, minus N. In second, so this is MN, minus 2NL, minus 2 LM is there. So first write M, then write L value here, minus M, minus N. What we have done in the earlier case, same thing we have to do. First line we are substituting in second. Now this is MN, minus into minus plus 2MN, then minus into minus plus 2N square, plus 2M square, plus 2MN. M square, N, MN, N square terms. M square terms, 2M square terms. MN terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5MN. Plus N square terms. So you have to arrange in that way. Squares, MN, N squares are opposite. In between, MN terms. Now factorize this 5. 2 to the 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. Now we have 2M common. M plus 2. Plus 1 common, plus N common, M plus 2. We have taken M plus 2 N, you will get here. M plus 2 N. Now M plus 2 N is common in both, so M plus 2 N into 2 M plus N. Common in one bracket, remaining in one bracket. Then what we will write? We will write lines now. First line. In this one, M plus 2N equal to 0 or 2M plus N is equals to 0. Because we have a line in form, LMN form, so we don't have L here, so we'll write 0L plus 1M plus 2N equal to 0. Third one, 0L plus 2M plus 1N equal to 0. This is equation 4. Then you need to solve 1 and 3. Same thing we'll do, solving 1 and 4. Once after substituting 1 into 2, we'll get 2 lines. Then by taking first one and third one, we'll get one direction ratios. First one and fourth one, you'll get another direction ratios. How to do that one? Second term, coefficient, see 1, 1, 1. Second, third, first, second term. Second term, third term, first term, second term. Then here, second term, third term is 2, first term is 0, second term is 1. Second term, third term is 1, first term is 0, second term is 2. L, M, N you have to take. Whereas in the straight lines unit, x, y, 1 we will take. Here we are finding ratios. So, second term, AD minus BC, AD minus BC, N by AD minus BC. So L by 1, M by minus 2, N by 1. L by minus 1, M by minus 1, N by 2. Direction ratios of line 1 is 1 minus 2, 1. These are ratios. In division, now whatever there in denominator is taken as ratios. Direction ratios of line 2. Minus 1, minus 1, 2. Now we have to find direction cosines actually. So for direction cosines, we have formula for direction cosines. DCs of line 1 is equals to A by root of A square plus B square plus C square, B by root of A square plus B square plus C square, and C by root over A square plus B square plus C square. A is 1. 1 by root over 1 square minus 2 square plus 1. Then minus 2 by root over 1 square minus 2 square plus 1. Then C is 1. 1 by root over A square plus B square plus C square. So this is 1 by root 6, minus 2 by root 6, and 1 by root 6. Similarly, direction cosines of line 2. Previously, we have angle from here. Suppose to find angle between them, cos theta equal to A1B1 plus A2B2 plus A3B3. In that way, you can fine. Here A by root of A is minus 1 by root over A square plus B square plus C square. Minus 1 square is 1. This is also 1. 4. 1 plus 1 plus 4. this is over. So DC is of line 1, DC is of line 2. Again, two lines are given. We'll write given equations L plus M plus N equal to 0 equation 1, L square plus M square minus N square equal to 0 equation 2. Put 1 into, but we are not equating 1 here, we are equating 1 here itself. L equals to minus M minus N in bracket in second one. Wherever L is there, minus M minus 1 will substitute. Both are having minus sign, so a plus b whole square here. Minus common within the bracket. Now a plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. This is m square minus n square. Then we have to cancel these two, minus n square plus n square. 2m square plus 2mn. Here no three terms are there, so no factorization. No factorization. You can take 2m common, m plus n. Here we can have 2m equals to 0 or m plus n equals to 0. This 2 goes to denominator, m is equal to 0 by 2 or m plus n equal to 0. We can write this one as lmn, 0l, 1m, we don't have n, 0n. Here 1m, lmn. Solving 1 and 3, solving 1 and 4. Here we have coefficients 1, second, third, first, second, third, first, second. In third one, second term 1, third term 0, first term 0, second term 1. Second, third, first, second. L M N. L divided by AD minus BC, M divided by AD minus BC, N divided by AD minus BC. L by minus 1, M by 0, N by 1. L by 0, M by minus 1, N by 1. Therefore, direction ratios of line 1 equal to minus 1, 0, 1. Then direction ratios of line 2. This is the process of getting direction ratios. Once we got, see, solving 1 and 2, we got this one. Okay. This is 0L plus 1M plus 0N. Okay. Now we have to find angle between them. So cos theta equals to A1A2 plus B1B2. Plus C1 C2 divided by root over A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into root over A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. Here A1 A2 these two minus 1 into 0 0 B1 B2 0 C1 C2 1 1 1 by root of A1 square minus 1 square 1 plus 0 plus 1. Here also squares of all the 1 plus 1 plus 1. 1 by root 2 into root 2 is 2. Cos theta is equals to cos 60 degrees. So we got angles. Theta equals to 60 degrees. In this way, we can get the value. So more problems are there. We'll discuss in the next video.